So I just finished watching Nightmare Alley, the newest film from Guillermo del Toro. Now, do we have the next Shape of Water on our hands? Is this film gonna win Best Picture and just sweep the Oscars like it did last time? Well, I was lucky enough to see this film early, and I'm gonna give you my quick thoughts right now. Hey buddy, how's it going? My name is Brandon, aka The Brando Critic, and I wanna say thank you so much for clicking on this video and being here. I'm sending you positive vibes your way. Today I'm gonna give you my honest, no BS, non-spoiler review for Nightmare Alley and tell you if it's worth a watch. If it's your first time here and you wanna see more early movie reviews just like this, first time movie reactions, and hangout live streams where we talk about movies, then definitely hit like and subscribe. I really do appreciate all the support. And come join the Brando Critic family. And don't forget about that bell notification so you never miss a single video. And please go check out my partners at Movie Scene Canada as well. Their link will be down below in the video description. So, we have Nightmare Alley from director Guillermo del Toro, and you know him from such films as Pacific Rim, Pan's Labyrinth, Shape of Water, and Blade 2, and Hellboy. And it stars Bradley Cooper, Cate Blanchett, Rooney Mara, Toni Collette, and Willem Dafoe, amongst a lot of other people. Ron Perlman even shows up in this movie too. And it's about a man who starts working at a carnival and starts to learn some of the psychological tricks behind mind reading and all those circus shows. And he takes all those manipulation tactics and starts his own show, and he makes tons and tons of money off of really gullible audience members. However, is this film worth a watch? I'm gonna say yes, but I think it depends on who you are. There are parts of this movie that I really enjoyed, and there are other parts of this movie where I was really bored and I felt like the pacing really took a nosedive. But let's get into it. In terms of the story, Nightmare Alley is essentially the Icarus story, about a man who has special talents, special gifts, and he's warned not to overuse them, but of course, he doesn't listen to those people and it ends up being his downfall, right? He flew too close to the sun. Now, putting that into contemporary movie form, this movie reminded me of Scarface in terms of its structure. Basically, the first half of the movie is him learning the trade, rising up through the ranks and rising to fame, glory, and power. But the second half of the movie is really about his pride and his ego and his lust and his greed being his ultimate downfall. Now, the first half of the movie, I was completely on board for. Bradley Cooper is a very charming actor and he does a great job here as well. And I love it when characters are learning a new skill and getting very passionate about it. And it makes you want to learn about that skill too. It's always a really good sign in a movie where you want to learn about the things that the character is learning about as well. I want to look up tarot cards and psychological tricks for mind reading and early 20th century carnivals. Like, if you guys don't know, I was actually a pretty big fan of magic when I was a kid and I learned a lot of card tricks and I still like doing it for people at parties. Yeah, no, it's pretty lame. I understand that. But, you know, I wanted to learn more about this stuff. And I just loved the style of the movie. This is a really gorgeous looking movie. Most of his movies are. Guillermo del Toro definitely has a very certain style. It's very sleek and it's very beautiful. And that definitely is here. And the production design is just top notch. I really do expect some awards or at least some nominations for this movie in terms of the cinematography, the production design, and the hair and the makeup. It all looks great. But I just love the atmosphere of the 1930s and 40s carnival scene. It's spooky, it's different, it's intriguing. And it definitely is mysterious because Bradley Cooper is running away from something in his past and he's trying to fill a hole inside of himself with mind reading and manipulating people so he can get a lot of money. Because this movie teaches us that we all have certain holes inside of us based on childhood trauma or just things we had to go through growing up. We all have that hole inside of us. Now we can try to fill it naturally or just try to heal ourselves. Or like some people like Bradley Cooper in this movie, we try to fill it with power, with money, with women, with drugs. And it's like that fork in the road, right? You can go down the path of righteousness and go through healing, or you can go down the pit of despair. So the first half of the movie, I was completely on board for. And then the second half of the movie starts. And you can immediately tell because it's a giant tonal shift. It's a giant time jump. And I'm like, oh my God. We're only halfway through the movie, aren't we? I check my watch, and I'm like, oh boy, this movie's going to be a long burn. And this is where I get into my problems with the movie. Some movies are 3 hours long, but they feel like they're 2 hours long. Braveheart, Lord of the Rings, Return of the King. The movie takes a while to end, I get that. The Wolf of Wall Street, other big movies, they are very, very long in terms of its runtime, but it doesn't feel long because I feel like every single minute of that runtime is used effectively. But then there are movies like this one, which are 2.5 hours long, but they feel like 4 hours because, quite frankly, I felt like the pacing was a real issue in this movie. The second half of the movie brings in Cate Blanchett, and she is a psychologist, and she is really trying to figure out what makes Bradley Cooper tick and why he's doing all these things. And quite frankly, in my own personal opinion, it is far less interesting than the first half of the movie. The first half of the movie was really intriguing because of the atmosphere of the carnival and Bradley Cooper learning all these tricks and him rising to the top. But then once he's at the top and it's his downfall, you can kind of see it coming. And the way that they go about it with Cate Blanchett doing all of these psychological tricks on him, I found to be rather uninteresting. And I will admit, even in the first half of the movie, I felt like the pacing was like, okay, where are we going? I'm intrigued because I'm in love with the atmosphere and I'm in love with the style of it all. But in the second half of the movie, I'm like, oh god, this is really dragging. I was checking my watch quite a few times, and like Lord of the Rings, this movie just doesn't end. However, when it does end, the final shot of the movie, no spoilers, it does hit you, and I'm like, okay, this movie is going full circle. I understand the entire point of the movie. However, just to get to that point, it's a bit sloppy in the middle. So for an overall rating, I'm giving this movie a 3 out of 5. I liked it. There are parts of this movie that I thought were rather boring and dragged, but for the most part, I think that the performances, the style, and the atmosphere, and the overall story does save it from being a dud. And I do think that this movie will get some Oscar nominations, and I think most people will like it. But overall, I do think it is an enjoyable movie for the most part. So now you know my thoughts of Nightmare Alley. What are yours? I'm curious to know what your thoughts are down in the comment section down below, so let me know. And thank you guys so much for sticking with me to the end of the video. If you want to see more videos just like this, then definitely hit that subscribe button. You can also find me on Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok at BrandoCritic. And again, guys, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.